terrifying day for Auckland. After laying dormant for nearly 600 years, the city's volcanic field is coming to life. Ironically, it's an absolutely stunning evening here in Auckland, the kind where everyone would usually be heading out to the beaches. Instead, we're waiting, not sure what to do next, not sure if this volcanic threat is real or not.
Yeah, we came last night actually when the earthquake started. We're heading out to Henderson, this is the place. It's already safe right there.
I'm trying not to panic. Hoping to wake up this morning and find it was all a bad dream, but fortunately not.
By 8 o'clock this morning, the roads out of the evacuation zone were gridlocked.
We're supposed to be fleeing for our life. The traffic's not even moving.
Despite instructions from civil defence authorities, many people from outside the evacuation zone joined the exodus, increasing congestion.
We're asking residents outside the red zone to stay in their homes until
soldiers from Papakura military camp joined forces with civil defence staff and police going door to door, making sure no one had been left behind. They also patrolled shopping centres to prevent looting. By mid-afternoon, the evacuated areas were ghost towns and the normally congested roads were empty. Throughout the afternoon, the earthquakes that set off the evacuation gradually became less frequent. But tonight, the city is still on level 3 alert.
Well, joining me now in the studio from Auckland University is Dr. Simon Barker. Doctor, can you tell us the earthquakes have become less frequent this afternoon? Does that mean the threat is receding?
Right, absolutely.
And safeguarding yourself.